thank you Vogue TV for this opportunity. How do I begin? I think some things are with you when you're born and some things you learn. So there is a lot of influence which has come from the family, the parents as well. So my mom, she took me to a dance school. Even before she took me to a school, I have very less memories of that time. But I have very faint memories, like, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's happening. And then, so my first time performing was on stage at the age of 3. And my mom says I got the first prize at that time in the entire school. It was... I hear all these stories later. So I was born in Siliguri, that's in the foothills of Darjeeling. It's the gateway to the whole northeastern India. Dad had a transferable job, normal middle class family. Every 2-3 years, dad used to have a transfer and then new school, new friends. So I guess a lot of culture and a lot of how to meet new people, new make new friends. That as I grew up, as you know, in Bengal, you know, it's kind of mandatory for the kids. They will put you in dance, singing,
something in acting, art.
Something in art. It's the environment is like that. So I remember in childhood, I used to crib like so much, you know, so much is going on. There is no time, like school ke baad ye, this, that. But after a certain age, I continued to pursue a couple of things. Like, I did not pursue my painting or drawing as much as I did dance or the singing part. So slowly, I went to college. Again, normal middle-class family. Engineer banogi ki doctor banogi. So I'm like, theek hai, engineer ban jate. So went into engineering. After that... got the campus placements. Then that was my first time outside of home, which was Bangalore. Bangalore gave me a whole new perspective thanks to the cosmopolitan culture of the city, I would say. Got to meet a lot of new people living alone, that independence initially, but it was exhilarating also, you know, first time out of home, manage everything alone. So, and I'm thankful to my corporate job also. I mean, I started with coding, of course, when they go, you know, we go into the training, they give us coding and all. But then my boss, when I was just, you know, 6 months into the job, he told, you know, once you're good with people, I'll give you a team you manage. So I'm like, okay, fine. I'm like, okay, and everybody was senior. So till today, I face that issue. Most of the people in my team, whom I manage, are my seniors. But I'm thankful I learn a lot from them as well. So slowly, I grew in that path also. I was going into these beauty pageants. I was getting some acting offers and all, but I was very skeptical. Because at the end of the day, I belong from a small town, middle-class family. And there was a lot of skepticism which belongs to this industry of, you know, becoming a full-time actor with the career, the uncertainty, a lot of things. So I'm like, okay. So I was traveling a lot due to my corporate job. I was posted in Sydney first, there, then they moved me to UK, then they moved me to Thailand. I was like here and there. There was just like childhood, you know, I was not in a place constantly. And I don't know, ghoomna meri kismat hai or what, but I was not able to stay in one place for a long time due to job. So, and in between, I spent some time in Mumbai also. And there, you know, again, meeting all these new people. I, there in Bangalore, as they say, everybody, if you throw a stone, it would land into an engineer's foot. In Mumbai, that's actors. So everybody around was struggling actor or writer or director. But I used to accompany them to sets. I had made a lot of friends there. I was in, you know, big Bollywood movie sets. I was privileged enough to be there, you know, observe the things, how the be a part of the crew. So I observed a lot of things, and frankly, I learned a lot. Just being on the sets day in and day out, assisted a lot of directors that time. Then again, my company moved me back to Bangalore. And then when I was in Thailand, one day I was like, really drinking tea by the window. I was like, what am I doing? I really want to be on a set. I really want to act. I really love that thing. You know, I feel so alive. And my friends also, they said, you know, camera ke samne you get a whole different personality, which doesn't come out in the other. So I think you should give it a serious try. So I told my boss, I want to go back to India. I'm like, again, your drama has started. Wherever we send you to Australia, after 6 months, you say, no, I want to come back. We send you to UK, after 6 months, you say, tell me you want to stay or no. I'm like, let me go. I want to be in India for some time. I really have some things to take care of. So then I came back. And then slowly, since I stayed in one place, the contact started building and I used to start getting calls for auditions and stuff. So that's how it all started. And here we are today, Ravi.
Superb. So what are the things you've seen during this particular transition?
I would say this is all about the career part. During this entire journey, my personal life took a lot of hits. And also during, in career also, there were a lot of hits. I mean, of course, there is this challenge of when you are younger and, you know, managing a larger team. At the end of the day, you're a brown woman and the people yeah. you're managing is, the people from Europe or Sydney or wherever. But I'm thankful I have had supportive people in my career. There were people who were openly like, you're younger than me, I'll not report to you. They're like, I won't work with you. That kind of people also I had. And I had people who are like 25, 30 years experienced and they come and they... Literally, they give me the update. I never ask for it. So those kind of people also exist. And I'm thankful they have become my mentors in turn, you know, to learn so many things from them, how to manage corporate politics, how to navigate that. So all those things. The learning has been tremendous, Ravi, if I can say. The acting job, you know, I never faced rejection in my life. Before I was rejected in auditions. So I think rejection teaches you a lot that every time, even if you think you are the best for that role, not necessarily everyone will think the same. So you have to deal with it. You have to move forward.
Yeah, I really like that. And some of the people, the initial introduction of yours was like completely in mute. I was like, though you could listen, the audience couldn't listen. That's the feedback I'm receiving. So yeah, people, friends who are, watching this, they, reason we, quick introduction. We're talking about why Amrita makes, us feel jealous with her profile. Three careers, acting, lady boss, and direction in the film, and why is she making everybody jealous with the way she is living her life? So that's the topic. That's a quick introduction about Amrita, and awesome initiative about I Am There. So maybe you can talk about I Am There, for you. What lovely hashtag. I think that short, I would say even three words, two words, means a lot. Self-explanatory. How did you start this?
Sure. So I think 2015-16 was a time I realized I'm in depression. As they say, even the things that you love the most, you don't get the feeling to do anything. You lose a lot of hope about life. And that time... I think the support that I received from my friends and family, they wanted to support me. But since the knowledge about how to support a person who is depressed is so less, so much less awareness is there. So there was a gap, which I felt with my life, that there is a gap. I used to get a lot of, oh, get over it. It will go off. Well, if I could get over it, I would, but it was not helping. Then I started connecting with, for my own depression, I connected with psychologist. And it was brief, and I mustered the courage to then fight it on my own. I just needed the courage and the right direction from there. But when I started talking to certain friends about my experience, they said, you know what, we also feel a lot of times like this, extended period of time like this, but we never consult a psychologist. And we never share it with our friends and family because we also get that you will get over it. Oh, forget it. Let's go for a party. It will be fine. Just hook up with someone. Or I mean, weird advices. Yeah. Weird. Go for a solo trip. Everything will get cured. And go to that mandir. Anything and everything. So
it doesn't just drink and get lost. You know. Yeah. But yeah, those might not be. Those might be like taking that temporary pill for you know body pains. It will not. You know. It will come back again.
Yes. Exactly. And then even we as individuals, how do we realize that we are in depression? Is it a temporary sadness? We are not getting that job or the personal relationship is not going out how we planned. So is it just that much or is it like you're losing, you know, the will to live? So we normal people, we also don't have so much of knowledge. We don't go deeper into these subjects. So then, but the most important part was I felt that if the same advice, you know, same warmth and support, if I talk to a stranger, if he gives me, I will receive it. It will give me a lot of moral boosting. But then if my dad, my mom, my sister, if they support me in the way I need it, there is a demand supply gap, basically, the kind of support I need and the kind of support I'm getting. So that will really, really motivate me. They know me the best since years. So they know what ticks me off, ticks me on. So that is required. They just need to know how to support me. And that's when Amler was born. At that time, I was participating in a pageant called Corporate Diva. It is not a beauty pageant. It is about ladies in corporate who are doing something beyond their normal jobs. So there I got a little bit mentorship also. And I was brainstorming these ideas. And then there was a program that what would you be an entrepreneur of if you are? So that time, and since I have this content creation skills, I just made a video about I'm there. And we screened it at the Corporate Diva finale. And people literally came to me after that finale. They had tears in their eyes. And I'm like, okay, that was a very moving moment for me. I started that hashtag on Twitter also, that hashtag I am there. Just please support your friends and family. You don't need to go beyond to the world to spread the message. You're giving so much of, you know, preaching messages and all. Start small, you know, your friend who has gone through a divorce may be depressed. Your friend who has lost the job may be depressed. You don't know. You're telling them to party. They may not be, that may not be the right solution for them. So just spread some love. Don't be critical. Don't be judgmental. That will help a lot of people. They'll open up slowly, and that's what we need.
Yeah, you know, one of the points that comes up, you know, during this particular discussion is what you rightly said. You know, I'm there. Support your friends. So it is not necessary for you to be a good friend. You always host a nice party, you know, which includes good food or you know drinks and stuff like that. It is important that if you can, you know, they feel comfortable then, you know, coming to you, sit and then express what they're going through. I think that is fulfilling. I think if you can build that particular confidence around your friends, nothing like it. So I think that should be the objective. Then, you know, this fancy stuff of, you know, food, party, you know, all that. Yeah, even we can get together where, you know, friends can meet, just express what went wrong, what went right during the, you know, entire week. That teases out. Superb. Ab kya chal raha hai? What's cooking now?
cooking a lot of things. I mean, right now I'm working on a script. I have never thought of this, like, you know, being a director, or I was creating content, of course, shooting videos and participating in film challenges, just utilizing my skills, whatever I've learned on the film sets. But this director thing, I never thought of. Lockdown made me a director, as it made different things of different people. So I was shooting things always with my mobile phone during the lockdown time. There were some film contests going on. They had some particular themes. So I spent a lot of time brainstorming and creating those ideas. One of those films within it is based on same mental health and also child abuse. So that's just a 3-minute film. And it got, you know, I did not have that thing that I will send it to festivals and all, but I did. My friends pushed me to do that. Some of them sent it, and surprisingly, it won awards at Lisbon, UK, and where not. And then they said, you know, you can tell a story. You should work on this skill as well. So right now, I'm working on few stories, few scripts, which are very close to my heart. So that's the next cooking. I just finished, wrapped up some of the short films that I've been, you know, pending for a long time due to the lockdown. So those dubbing, those all the, you know, technical part of it is done. I'm now trying to take a little bit time off to work on my scripts and then make something out of it.
Super. There are a lot of artists, you know, coming up, and you know, as you rightly said, lockdown, and you know, Work TV is also one of the lockdown stories, you know, accidental companies which have come up during the lockdown. So what is the message you have for, you know, people who are now coming up with like short films, or you know, into direction or into acting?
First thing is, Ravi, I would like to share this with everyone, that I also have a theater background. I'm a trained actor from a theater. I've done several acting workshops and all. But even that could not give me the, you know, learning of how to make a film if I was not on a film set. The being, you know, just to be on a film set as an intern, as a crew, as a side actor, junior actor, whatever. Just being there day in and day out, night to day, day to night, and seeing how the things work, how the lightmen put their light, how the costume people, you know, what goes behind making those costumes, every little detail. I think noticing all that, learning the process, that is very important. Now that I'm into writing, and I, you know, assist in the production house, and I create films myself. A lot of my friends or a lot of new actors also definitely come to me. They keep on sending their profiles. But if they come to the set, that knowledge is missing. So I think it's very important to intern. It's be an intern or be a crew member, whatever, but learn it first, learn all the aspects of filmmaking, at least some aspects of filmmaking, before you try to be an actor. It helps in two ways. One, you have the knowledge required for it, and second, you will see the non-glamorous process behind it. Then your decision or your intention will become clearer. Do you really want to pursue this? What goes behind is not as glamorous as what you see on screen. So if you get frightened by that, it's not a good decision to become an actor. If you think that I can survive all of it for a larger part of my life, the only then acting in acting.
Yeah, good point. You know, there are a lot of professions which look really good, you know, rosy outside, but you know, behind the scenes, it's like completely different. A lot of hard work and a lot of patience is required. So good. We have some rapid fire questions, Amrita. So are you all set, ready?
I think I would be.
Okay. Are there any laws or social rules that completely baffle you? You know, society may some rules which you feel these are like odd, or you know, should not be really there.
That you should get a job before 25, that you should get married before 30, that you should have kids. Once you have the first kid, you should have the second kid. And the cycle.
Yeah, I know. You know, this is very common. Like when I go to my hometown, the first thing they ask is, kya kar raha hai? Matlab, kahin job mila ki nahi? एंड द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज, हाँ मिल गया करना, कितना देते हैं? ओके, आई मीन दे वेरी, मतलब इट इट द क्यूरियोसिटी, एंड वो प्यार से भी बोलते हैं कितना देते हैं. ओके, द थर्ड क्वेश्चन विल कम, शादी हो गई एंड देन कितने बच्चे हैं? यू नो, यू गो टू दिस विलेजेस एंड ऑल दैट, मेट्रोज दिस इज नॉट वेरी यू नो कॉमन, बट यू गो टू योर होम टाउन एंड ऑल दैट, दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, कितने बच्चे हैं, क्या कर रहे हैं एंड ऑल दैट. सो या, आई कंप्लीटली एग्री विथ यू, यू नो दिस हैज टू चेंज.
टिक टिक टिक
ओके, यू नो नाउ दैट यू आर सिंगल, व्हाट आर देर आर एनी हाउस होल्ड कोर्स दैट यू रियली एंजॉय सीक्रेटली?
एंजॉय
या नो?
आई यूज टू एंजॉय कुकिंग रवि, बट इन लॉकडाउन व्हेन आई हैड टू कुक फॉर एवरी डे आई लॉस्ट द इंटरेस्ट फॉर दैट. हाउस होल्ड चोज आई एक्चुअली लाइक क्लीनिंग, यू नो आई लाइक टू कीप नीट एंड टाइडी हाउस, but it's very hectic, you know. Now I realize how mom and grandma, how they kept the
Very
house
true.
so beautiful. It's so hectic.
Yeah. So, are you living your life purpose, or are you still searching for it?
I think I'm on the way.
On the way.
At least that girl who was standing in the balcony in Thailand, I am happier than her. Although she was making more money than I am, and having more parties than I am, and having a larger social group or social life that time, but I think this Amrita is happier.
Cool. So with this experience where you've been a boss, you're managing a lot of people as a leader with good people skills, you're interacting, you're also directing. Can you tell if somebody is lying in front of you?
I don't think so. I have a lot of what to say, not so pleasant experiences. I have trusted a lot of people. I still tend to trust. I'm very straightforward. I tell it how it is. So that thing is still in me, but I feel this other person will
या
also do
लोग भी
the
ऐसे हैं.
same. Log bhi aise hain. So I nowadays since so much of things have happened, I try to think and judge. But then I'm like, okay, what will happen? चलो रिस्क ले लेते हैं if somebody says something. So yeah, I'm not good at that, not at all.
थैंक्स फॉर बीइंग ऑनेस्ट. बहुत लोग बोल रहे हैं या आई कैन मेक आउट, बट या थैंक्स फॉर बीइंग ऑनेस्ट. ओके, अपार्ट फ्रॉम ट्रस्टिंग पीपल, व्हाट इज द कॉमन मिस्टेक यू कीप रिपीटिंग?
Yeah, the biggest one I told you. I think I still sometimes I am lot less confident than I should be. I mean, this my friends also tell me, like when I directed this film, within I created this one, it was just going to sit in the hard drive of my computer, and had it not, you know, I had not shown to some of the friends, and they pushed me to send it. So I am very critical of my work. I don't think it is very good unless somebody really pushes me. You know, no, it is good. You send it, see for yourself. So how it is done. So I think I still need to work on my confidence, but some about the quality of my you know work, not other things, but the films I make, the content I create. I'm a little underconfident, and I'm trying to overcome that. I'm working on it.
Super. You've been traveling a lot, right? And you know, obviously traveling single. Okay, it's almost like a paid solo trip by your company. Okay, what is the funniest or most embarrassing, you know, pickup lines you've heard? You know, obviously you know when you're traveling, ये सभी होते हैं तो.
Yeah, so very, I mean, lot of interesting things. But you know, when it comes to pickup lines, I think it doesn't differ too much in different parts of the world. It is still in many places, it's still, can I buy you a drink? It starts with that. But there are some really weird lines like, is your dad a terrorist because you're a bomb? I mean, like,
Oh my
it's
God.
Crazy. I mean, you won't even look at that person after that, but they continue to use all those lines. But yeah, I mean, a lot of funny experiences there. A lot of times, I was getting asked out, but since my friends are there, they're like, no, these people are not good for you. These people are foreigners and all. No, don't get into all this and all. So I had a lot of fights also with my friends. We are in nightclub and I broke my shoe. I danced so much. And then one British guy comes and tries to ask me out. And I'm surrounded by a group of friends. And one of the friends, no, don't do all this, She's our friend. He didn't see a line also. So a lot of funny stories on that aspect.
Yeah, safeguarding friends is, wo that overrides what you're really expecting versus इन लोग भी, और मैंने पूछा भी नहीं था, इन लोग भी सेफगार्ड कर रहे हैं. द बेस्ट कॉम्प्लीमेंट यू रिसीव्ड?
That your heart is as beautiful as your soul.
सुपर, गुड वन. द क्यूटेस्ट केक ड्यूरिंग योर चाइल्डहुड? ओके, चाइल्डहुड मेमोरीज विच यू स्टिल रिमेंबर, द केक.
I think the one that was home baked, it was in like in our middle class Bengali family, there was not so much of cake, but there was a lot of kheer and all. We call it paish in Bengali. So I remember mom used to serve it on a small katori, and my dad would feed me. I was in the godi, and I was like so small, and they would feed. And that tradition continued even now. If I will go, then mom will make kheer. I'm like, don't put so much sugar in that kheer. No, it is birthday kheer. How can I not put sugar? It has to be the sweetest kheer.
Sweetest,
Oh God, it's so sweet.
yeah. So, have you stolen anything? Money, candy, hearts, time?
Not money, not hearts. Yeah, people. How you get approached to people say that. Like that, but I don't like to steal anything. I would rather appreciate if somebody says you touched my heart rather than you stole my heart.
Have you pushed your body, so hard for your dream or, your project or the work, because you're into acting where, you had to really push hard your body to, get fit or, look good? Have you done that before?
Yes. I have pushed. There is one instance when I was in Mumbai. Remember December 2016. I was auditioning. I was in terrible pain. I had fallen on the road badly, but then I had two auditions in two big Mumbai studios, well-known studios. So I went on with that, and I hurt so bad. That night, I had a flight back to Bangalore. I had to come back in wheelchair in the night, 12 a.m. So, and then my feet was plastered for a month. So, a lot of, yeah, you have to push your body.
If you're directing a movie and where you do not want to showcase your name, so what is the pen name, or I don't know, what is it called? If it's a book, it's called a pen name, right? So you have a different name. If it's a film, you want to keep it anonymous, not to disclose the world. What would you name it, and what subject would you shoot
That's
where
really interesting.
you don't want to reveal yourself?
Okay. Maybe on top of my mind, maybe parrot. And why? Because I will have the flexibility to move around in the set. And I would name it Twitter.
Twitter. Cool.
Lot of chatter, a lot of Twitter there.
Superb. So with all this experience, you're also setting a good example, of women getting empowered, women leading their life, women living their life in their own way. With all this experience, what would you do if you become the chief minister? What are the positive reforms you would focus on to bring in for the state or for the nation?
I think we are doing good in terms of, see, now COVID is the burning issue, of course. Maybe amp up even more the infrastructure that we have. That's the first thing. Second is regarding education. I think our education system is a little bit different than what we need in the practical life. Maybe we should introduce few things like how to do your taxes, how to, talk to people, make new friends, all those skills, which life skills, basically. I think they should be included. Then, as you said, a lot of women empowerment talk is going on these days. We are speaking up. We have financial independence now. But then, what we are not teaching is our sons. We are focusing so much on the women empowerment part. We are forgetting there's a whole entire population that needs to know how to deal with this sudden, empowered changes in the society. So that, and how will the sons learn if we don't teach them? They will learn from their family only. So we cannot blame somebody that how are you behaving like this if the society or the infrastructure is not supporting them. So we need to make that ecosystem where everyone has a gender equality and people are judged based on their talent, their skills. They're not the first look that, okay, this is a girl or this is even for a boy, that should not be there, that since he's a male, he should be able to do these things. I mean, people are differently skilled these days, and maybe some male is very good in painting or cooking rather than lifting weights. So this typecast thing has to really, we need to get it in our system that let's not typecast people, let's not make boxes out of people there. So yeah, I think these things, starting from the family to the ecosystem, somewhere in the syllabus, slowly, empathy, of course, so that we know how to support each other.
Nice thoughts, Amrita. Nice knowing you again. Still jealous. I mean, yeah, though you tried to convince so much. Yeah, all the best at whatever you do. I agree. Some of these things have a lot of questions. You know, some of this, the life which you live will have a lot of, questions and, a lot of ifs and buts. A lot of people, give you a lot of gyan, which you really don't need. Instead of taking you as an inspiration, they will try to impose whatever they can, whatever comes into their mind. But yeah, all the best with what all the projects, initiatives that you go ahead. End of the day, when you turn 30s, 40s, 50s, when you look back, the only thing which you should look at is क्या मैंने वो किया है जो मैं करना चाहती हूँ. आई थिंक दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. चाहता हूँ. सो आई थिंक इट्स अप्लाइज फॉर बोथ द जेंडर्स. सो इफ मेन कैन डू, आई हैव लॉट ऑफ फ्रेंड्स हु नॉट गॉट मैरिड, वॉन्टेड टू बी सिंगल. इफ दे कैन टेक अ डिसीजन दैट एज मैन दे डोंट वॉन्ट टू गेट मैरिड. आई ऑल्सो हैव फ्रेंड्स हु आर सिंगल. So why that differentiation? I think both the genders should have that particular thing and let them decide when they want to settle down. So until then, keep exploring. So all the best, do well, and God bless you for all your initiatives. Would love to see follow you and see all the acting skills, direction skills, and watch how you are evolving in your life. So friends, do follow Amrita. We'll share the social handles where she is available. So sorry about the initial introduction where I was talking, though Amrita could hear what my introduction, but you guys couldn't hear. So thank you, Amrita. It's so nice knowing you, and so, we need women like you who can open up, openly talk about what your life preference is, honestly.
Thank you so much, Ravi, for this wonderful time. It's been a pleasure talking to you, and the kind of questions or the things that you asked, it some of them made me think also in a few areas I was not prepared. Okay, this I have not thought before. So thank you for this lovely, lovely session, and I'm also your big fan, Ravi. I also follow you on the social media. So, and I think this lockdown, as you said, work TV lockdown stories, I think bringing up the people with passion, that's an amazing work that has been going on. So this, of course, gives a platform to share the thoughts that we have, you know, with the larger group of people. And the only thing is, if a, you know, a small town girl from a middle class family can do it,
Something.
then probably anyone can do it. So that's what. So thank you so much, Ravi, for having me.
And God bless with your initiative on I'm There. Lovely initiative. So, yeah, you're doing so much back to the society. So, God bless. Have a great day, great evening, guys. Thank you, Amrita.